Now, to the world of health now, and how would you feel if your young child was diagnosed and prescribed medication without even getting involved? On the face of it, it may not sound like something many parents would like.
But a new scheme which does just that is getting rave reviews from families in Hamilton. It's the brainchild of health campaigner Dr. Lance O'Sullivan. His mission? To break down treatment barriers. Lucas de Jong explains.
When you can't take your baby to work, you have to ring in a sub.
You're my son, eh? Yes, you are. You're my son. You're my pretend son. We're going to daycare, eh? A little Elijah de Jong.
From the kids bonding over bubbles to the ones making mountains with mates. Sometimes there are unwanted visitors at kindy.
School sores, cold sores, ringworms, eczema, head lice.
Oh no!
A lot of our children come from disadvantaged homes and they come representing all sorts of ailments that could easily be fixed.
They were little problems that had staff here
pushing children out the door. But now with the program, we can actually go beyond that caring within our facility.
The program is iMoko. It starts with a trained daycare worker, played by this little dude, spotting a problem.
They're itchy.
Oh, you've got nuts in your hair.
There's nuts.
They gather the details.
I'm on the person in your ear. Cold.
I'm cold.
And enter it all into the iMoko app.
Do you think the doctors will be able to fix me?
Yes, they might.
That info is sent to a team of qualified doctors. They assess and supply a solution.
Medicine. He likes champagne.
And a prescription can be ready for parents at the end of the day.
Did you fix me?
No!
You're not very good doctors, are you?
I am a good one. I know I can
treat you better. Looking at what we are doing on a daily basis makes me incredibly proud. Child has these problems.
iMoko is the brainchild of health hero Dr. Lance O'Sullivan.
Globally, digital health and virtual health are coming to the fore. What we did was digitise these nursing and medical services to enable these services to be more readily available.
Best Start in Hamilton has been trialling it for a few months.
We weren't too sure which way it was going to go.
Staff here receiving specialised training.
Can you just look up, darling?
Before selling the scheme to parents.
They've come to rely and trust the program and know that we teachers who are doing the iMoko, it comes from a place of love and care.
The kids are healthier and it's also a blessing for busy parents.
I'm a single mum, I work full time. I don't always have the time to come and drop everything and pick him up if he's sick. For me, just to be able to go and pick up a prescription once I finish work, yeah, it works perfectly for me.
This isn't a case of I'm going to drop my kid off in the morning and pick up a heavily medicated child in the afternoon, is it?
Even though we may have the antibiotics with us, we cannot administer that until the parents give us permission.
Now...
Oh, we've got more food, Wayne.
Best Start is taking iMoko national.
The vision I had when I first talked to Lance about the possibilities of the difference iMoko could make to the children in our centres are being fulfilled.
Now we have close to 10,000 children across New Zealand and 160 sites.
The digital doctor that's looking after your kids.
Now you're done. Take my hand,
we'll be fine. And my make-believe one.
They grow up so fast.
It's interesting, actually, Hills, because your kids are a little bit older now and mine have just come out of that preschool. Mine are just at school 6 and 8. And there is a time, they've just got to that point now where they're not sick the whole time, whether it's hand, foot and mouth or whether it's croup.
No, they all get everything, don't they?
Everything.
It is such a fantastic initiative, such a fantastic initiative. And just to repeat, non-serious ailments, so we're talking, you know, nits and eczema and all those sorts of things that they pick up and they share with everybody. But great initiative and great for really remote communities as well, where a doctor is a long way off. Fantastic.
Have you, how are you going with the, have you got rid of your nits?
The funny thing is, Jeremy did see me itching because every time people talk about nits, I just start itching.
I've never had them.
I don't
They don't like me. They're nits. They don't like me.
I don't like dirty hair, apparently.